Have you ever wanted to be an astronaut as a kid? If so, this might be your chance. For the first time since 2008, the European Space Agency, or ESA, is recruiting new astronauts, and its focus, diversity.
It's really important to have diversity as it helps us to make things better. Diversity is not a burden for us. Diversity is an asset for us.
For the first time in history, ESA is opening the doors for astronaut wannabes with physical disabilities through its Para-Astronaut Feasibility Project. According to the job posting on ESA website, the agency is looking for individuals who are psychologically, cognitively, technically, and professionally qualified, but have a physical disability that would normally prevent them from being selected. And by physical disability, ESA refers to a lower limb deficiency, leg length difference, and short stature. Candidates with mental disability and/or other physical disabilities, such as blindness and deafness, will not be considered for the current pilot program, but ESA says it hopes to open the program further. Other requirements apply to para-astronaut candidates as well. The candidates should be fluent in English, have a master's degree or higher, and at least 3 years of professional experience in the field of natural sciences, medicine, engineering, mathematics, or computer science. Be calm under pressure, and be willing to participate in life science experiments. The candidates who meet all of these requirements will need to go through 6 levels of recruitment process. At the end, 4 to 6 will be selected to be career astronauts who will be permanent ESA staff, and about 20 will be selected as reserve astronauts who could fly for shorter missions to destinations like the International Space Station. There is no specific quota for para-astronauts, and there is no guarantee that a para-astronaut will actually go to space.
We think it's something we just have to do. We know there are challenges, so I can't tell you when, but in a few years' time, and not too far after the new group of astronauts are flying, we need to make this happen.
ESA is really working for better inclusion and diversity amongst its astronaut pool. So far, 90% of agency's astronauts have been men, and it has sent only 2 women into space. And only 16% of the applicants for the last recruitment round in 2008 were women. So the agency is really trying to revamp its diversity status and open doors to more people of different background, gender, age, and now physical disability.
Visible representation is always important, and so therefore we've been asking ourselves, what are the barriers preventing us to fly a physically disabled astronaut to the ISS and to work there? So we feel we have a responsibility to at least try and make this happen and lead by example. So we hope to push the envelope on the topic of disability at work and inspire people with special needs to apply to other roles in ESA and more widely in the space industry. Right now we're at step 0. The door is closed to such people. We want to change that, and we want to go from 0 to 1.
As of now, none of the space agencies in the United States are open to recruiting disabled astronauts. But hopefully, ESA's Para-Astronaut Feasibility Project paves a way for out-of-this-world representation. The application for the Para-Astronaut Feasibility Project will be open for 8 weeks, starting on March 31st. The new astronaut class will be announced in the second half of 2022.
We did not evolve to go to space. So when it comes to space travel, we are all disabled. You know, we all have a disability because we were just not meant to be up there. So what brings us from being, you know, disabled to go to space to being able to go to space is technology.
It's the right time to be asking those probing questions, the right time to be thinking, actually, it's about ability, it's not about disability. And is it feasible, is it possible to actually, you know, have people with disabilities flying into space? I wouldn't have any concerns.
So in the end, it's just a matter of, do we want to invest in the technology, in the necessary adaptations of space hardware?
We want to know what you think about ESA's Para-Astronaut Feasibility Project. Let us know in the comment section below, and make sure to like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel at Dream Young Media. Thanks for watching.